Hey friends, it's Sam and Hurley, and welcome to another video. Now, I've released quite a few card making products over the past year, and there are certain ideas I've wanted to try with each product, but some I didn't get a chance to. So in today's video, I'm going to show a ton of different techniques using lots of card making products, so hopefully you learn a ton from this video. If you want to check out any of the supplies I'm using, I'll have everything I use linked down below, and using those links helps support me, so I really appreciate it. Alright, without further ado, let's get into the video. Alright, so first let's start off by making an ink blended background. I'm going to start off by taking a little bit of mint tape, because I always like to tape down my cardstock to the surface just to make sure it doesn't move. So I'm looping down a little bit of mint tape and I'll place it down onto my surface. Then I'm going to go in using the Deco diamond stencil. I love this one, it gives a really beautiful Art Deco look and it's got some really great fine details in the stencil. So I'll just line it up how I want and then I'll grab a little bit more mint tape and I'm going to tape it down to my surface to make sure that it doesn't move as we do our stenciling. I love mint tape because even if it goes on top of your cardstock, it doesn't rip your cardstock because it's nice and low tack, which is perfect. All right, now for my ink blending, I'm gonna use Prom Queen, Shooting Star, and Clear Skies. And this is a really awesome technique to use a red, a yellow, and a blue as well. I really recommend it because you'll create new colors in between and it'll create kind of a rainbow effect. So I'm going in using these Altenew blending brushes and I'm just going to go right onto the surface and start blending out my color. Now the reason I'm using these Altenew blending brushes is because they got a nice large surface area so we're really easily able to cover a lot of the stencil at once, which I really love. But also, I really love blending brushes, especially when you've got a bunch of tiny little pointed details like this, because the bristles of the brush really get down into those little details and capture all of it, whereas sometimes foam blending tools will just kind of go over top of the surface and not hit every little tiny detail. So that's why I love brushes like this. So I'm gonna overlap it over top of that pink, and you can see we're creating a nice orange color in between there. And then again, I'll carry down the yellow a little bit further so that we can blend that in together with the blue. So down here, I'm going in using a little bit of Clear Skies. I'll ink up my blending tool, and then we'll go right down here and blend this out. And again, I'm going to overlap it with the yellow, and you can see there we create a nice green color in between. So since these are translucent dye-based inks, instead of layering on top of each other and covering things up, it's just going to overlap and create new colors. So if you look on a color wheel, the yellow and the blue is gonna create a nice green in between, which is just so awesome. So if you only have three colors, I'd recommend a red, a yellow, and a blue, because you'll create this beautiful rainbow. All right, so then we'll lift off the stencil and check out that beautiful background that we've created. I absolutely love it. All of that amazing fine detail was captured. And like I said, those blending brushes get into those small little areas and give you great crisp details. Now I wanna create a shaker card window, so I'm gonna be using the Brilliant Butterflies die set to do so. I love this one because it's got shadow dies that will create kind of a window effect, or it's got the detailed dies to create the really detailed butterflies. For this one, I'm gonna use this butterfly right here, this kind of medium-sized butterfly, and I'll use one of the smaller ones for kind of a layered effect as well. But I also love the different options of sizes you get a ton of versatility in this set. So I brought in my platinum die cutting machine, and I'm going to place down that mid-sized butterfly sort of in the center, right about there on kind of an angle as well. And that's going to be the window that we cut out for the shaker card. So I'll place down my plate and we'll run this right through the die cutting machine. All right, then we'll lift that out and it cuts out that great window for our shaker card, which is really nice. And you also have this butterfly, which you can pop out all these little pieces and you get this beautifully colored butterfly. I'll set this off to the side because we're not gonna use it on today's project. I'm gonna grab a piece of scrapbook.com acetate. I love that they have packs of this because it tends to be clearer and more clean than packaging. So I like to just use a piece of acetate, but again, plastic stamp packaging would work just as well here. And I'll just trim this down to a little bit larger than I need for the window. And once we've got that, we can flip this over and I'm just gonna go in and add some tape runner adhesive all the way around this window. So just add it quite close to that butterfly window. Some people use liquid adhesive here, but I tend to find that tape runner is a little bit more helpful because it has no dry time and it sticks instantly. It's not as quite as messy either. So then I can go in here with my acetate and place this right down over top of that window. And there we've created a nice acetate piece. All right, then I'm gonna bring in my large 3M roll of foam tape. I love this. It's a lot more cost effective to buy a larger version like this. It's an investment up front, but I really recommend it. I'll have this linked down below in the description. But what's really awesome about this is I can just go in and take quite a large piece without feeling too bad about it since there's a lot here. I'll rip it off, and then we can go in and double it up. So since we want to add quite a bit of shaker bits and have them shake around freely, I'm going to fold this tape right on itself, follow all the way along to make sure it's nicely lined up. Then to avoid anything sticking to the sides, while this tape is still on here, I'm gonna go in with my anti-static powder tool, and I'm just going to powder the edges of this tape. That way, if there's any stickiness showing, we can get rid of it really easily before we put down our sequins. Because if you've ever made a shaker and had things sticking to the side, that is why, so be sure to add some anti-static powder tool. All right, the next step is creating kind of a canal for this shaker window. So I'm just going to add a foam tape all the way around. And as you add this foam tape, you wanna go pretty close to the butterfly's edge, and then you want to butt the foam tape up to the last piece, making sure they touch and that there's no gap in there. All right, so I'll just continue this all the way around, making sure to touch the last one. And this makes a great window for those sequins to sit in and that nothing is going to escape. And then I'll use any excess foam tape all the way around the edges to make sure that the outside pieces are the same height. All right, then I've grabbed a stark white top folding card base that I've cut and folded. And I'm going to go in with some clear sparkly sequins. These are kind of like flat confetti sequins. Place them down on the surface of my card. All right, and that seems like a good amount, and kind of crowd them towards the center or wherever area you have your window on your card. That way it'll fit right inside of there. And I find that this way is less of a mess than trying to put it inside of here and flipping this. And then I'll just line it up and adhere this right down onto my card. And you wanna make sure you press this all down and make sure that foam is fully adhered to the surface before you start moving and shaking anything on your card. And once I've adhered it, we can give it a good shake and you can see just how fun and interactive this butterfly is. So once you kind of hold it like this, everything goes down and then you can shake it around and you've got some great interactive pieces. I love all that shine in there. All right, then I'm gonna grab a piece of stark white cardstock and I'm gonna grab this little mini butterfly and die cut it out as well so we can have those to layer up on the shaker card. I'm gonna cut it out twice too. Okay, and once these little guys are cut out, we can just go in with the tool in one tool from Spellbinders. I love this little pokey brush because you can really easily go in and get rid of all of the little detail pieces so you have these nice intricate butterflies. I think the coolest part about this butterfly set is having different size ones, because to finish off this card, I want to use these little butterflies to make it look like they're kind of all fluttering in one direction on the card. So I'm gonna go in using a little bit of liquid glue and I'll just add it to the center of these butterflies so that the wings are still able to kind of flutter around. And then I'll go in and adhere them right down onto the card. And I cut these out using white because I don't want them to stand out too much. I want the center butterfly to mainly be the focal point. And for these, just to be something you kind of notice as you look at the card. And then I'll aim this one in the other direction and adhere it down. Now for the sentiment, I'm gonna pull out a sentiment from the Butterfly Kisses stamp set. I love all these because they coordinate really well with the different butterflies. One thing I like to do is bring back in the card and just see what fits really well in here. We could do fluttering by to say hi. I think that would be great. I think that actually fits the best. So I'm gonna use fluttering by to say hi. So I'm gonna do a little bit of heat embossing. So I'll bring in my anti-static powder tool to make sure that no powder sticks where we don't want it. And then I'll go in using a little bit of Versamark clear sticky ink to stamp down the sentiment onto some black cardstock. Then I'll bring in my white heat embossing powder, which I have inside of this container. So it's really easy to dump over top. And I'll blow off any of the excess powder to make sure there's none where we don't want it. Then I'll heat set this till it's nice and bright white. All right, then to give this sentiment a more finished look, I'm just going to go in and fussy cut right around the sentiment. Instead of leaving it on a larger rectangle, I feel like this makes it look a little bit better. To do this, I'm using my Fisker's Spring Assist scissors, which spring back out at you so your hands don't get tired, which is really nice. All right, then I'll place down the sentiment on some foam tape, and I love how it stands out against the colorful background. And there's a closer look at the finished card. I love that ink blended background using the Deco diamond stencil and using just three colors to create that beautiful rainbow blend. And then of course, finishing it off to create that really great interactive shaker card using the Brilliant Butterfly set was so awesome. I've been wanting to try that out with the window die in the center and then using some of those smaller butterflies. For this next card, I'm gonna do something that I don't usually do, and I'm gonna create a 5x7 card. So for this, I've cut down my cardstock to 10 inches by 7 inches, and I'm gonna go in and score it right at the 5-inch mark. And my scoreboard is a little small, so all I need to do then is just flip it over and score it down at the 5-inch mark on the other side. And then we'll flip this over and we can crease it down using our Teflon bone folder. Super easy. So there we have our nice large 5x7 card, and I've also cut a piece of stark white cardstock to be a little bit smaller so we have a nice border around it, and this is what I'm going to work on. And for this card, I want to go in and do some color blocking using the Paint Swatches stamp set. This one is so fun because they're really nice and solid, and I'm going to use this great solid circle for some of the techniques. All right, so for this first one, I'm going to go in using a little bit of Guppy ink, and I'm going to ink up this whole paint swatch, and it's really nice and solid. So we did these images in red rubber, so they stamp a little bit better with a really great solid impression, but there's also kind of pieces and little splotches missing, which I think makes these paint swatches so much fun. So then I'm going to go in using a little bit of Prom Queen, and I'm just going to kind of roll this onto the edge of the paint swatch to get another color blend in there, and then I'll go in and spray this down with some water. I'm gonna just mist it down a couple times because I want a really great watercolor look from this. So the more you spray it down and get the water moving, the more of a painted type effect you're going to get. Then I'll go in, line this up, kind of right in the center, but on the right side, and then I'll stamp it down, giving it some good pressure to make sure that everything transfers nicely. And when we lift that off, check out that really beautiful watercolor looking effect that we have. I love the blend in there, and it created such a perfect paint swatch, just like the name. Now for this top one, I wanna go a little bit lighter, so I'm using some yellow shooting star ink. I'm going to ink this up again, and I'm going to go in on the edge and add a little bit of shading again. And once again, just going in and misting it down to get a really great watercolor effect, and line it up and stamp it down. And it's kind of overlapping, but I'm stamping it on the left side this time. And there we go, another really great watercolor effect. And I love how it gets darker where they overlap too. All right, last but not least, we'll use a little bit of Bee Sting at the bottom for a nice red color. I love this really great bright red color. And then to make this one a little bit darker, I'm going in using my maroon color, which is called Game Over. And I'll just roll this on the edge to create again a darker looking blend. And then again, we'll stamp it down, giving it some good pressure to make sure that it transfers, and another really beautiful watercolor effect. And I love how perfect and seamless it is every time. It's got those little skipped areas too, which makes it really fun and effortless. And now what's really awesome about these is they create great little grounding places for some critters or images on your cards. So for this one, I'm gonna use the spring chicken set, and I'm gonna color in a couple little chickens that we can use for little scenes on here. I love how fun and kind of awkward this set is. I'm gonna grab a couple of these chickens. And I'll stamp these guys out using some VersaFine Claire Nocturne ink to get a really nice solid jet black inking. And I'm going to stamp them down onto my Simon Hurley Create Stark White cardstock. And check out that beautiful stamped image. All right. And I think it's just the really fun and playful nature that's so awesome about these images. I'm gonna go in and do a little bit of watercoloring, so a little bit of clear heat embossing ink will help kind of set this ink into place. So we'll just lay that over top, tap off the excess, and heat set this until it's nice and clear and shiny. All right, so I'm just gonna lay down some colors that I want to use for these chickens, using a little bit of clear skies, and then we'll go in with some of the yellows as well. So some over the moon, some guppy, and some red, and I'm just sort of laying a palette down of color onto my craft sheet. Once that's done, I'm gonna go in here with a brush and we can start our painting. Now, I always like to start off with just a layer of water first. This prepares the cardstock to take the ink and will make it flow a little bit better on the surface rather than just going straight in with the color, because then it'll sink down into the surface and not blend. Whereas now we can go in with our color and it's going to give a nice wash of color over top of the surface and blend a lot smoother. And what I love so much about these chickens is they're just fun and playful, so you don't have to take the coloring too seriously. So here I'm going in using a little bit of blue for this guy's stomach, and then we'll bring it back in to a little bit of the yellow and sort of blend the colors together. You don't want to blend them too much because these would sometimes create mud, but I think it's going to be a fun color blend for this. And I got the inspiration to color them like this from my friend Suzanne Hugh from A Creative Muse. I'll link to her channel down below. She's super inspiring, and she sort of colored them like the chicken from Moana, which I thought was so adorable. And if you want a darker tone of the color too, add a little bit less water, and then you can add some shading down to it. So go back into the color, more concentrated, to add some darker shading. Now what's awesome is that these chickens have a coordinated die set too. So I'll pick out the dies that I want to use to match these guys. We'll line them up with an even border and then hold them in place using a bit of mint tape to make sure they don't shift while we run through our die cutting machine. These are such a big time saver, especially with really detailed images like these chickens, to be able to go in and just cut them out with the coordinating die set. All right, then I'll run this right through. Pop these right out and check out just how perfectly they cut out. Super easy, and they've got a nice white border around the images as well to make them stand out from the background. All right, then I'll position them where I want them, and I'm going to use a little bit of foam tape again to pop them off the surface and give it a little bit of dimension. Then I'll place this guy right down here, and I'll place this one right up here. And you can see just how great those paint swatches are to highlight the different chickens on the card. I just love it. All right, now it's time to stamp down some sentiments from the set. So I'm going to use the sentiment that just says cock-a-doodle-doo. We're going to stamp that down right at the top, coming out of that rooster's mouth. Then I'm going to use the sentiment that says it's your birthday and stamp it right in the center here. So I'll kind of stamp it at an angle like that. And then last but not least, one of my favorite sentiments from the set, it says you're still a spring chicken. And I'm just going to stamp this right at the bottom, follow along with the bottom chicken down there. And how cool is that? It makes a sentiment that says, cock-a-doodle-doo, it's your birthday, but you're still a spring chicken. I love that, and I love that we've created those three different areas using the paint swatches to really highlight those adorable chickens all throughout the card. It's a great way to build a scene and give each one a grounding place, and such a fun and playful birthday card. If you have this stamp set or one like it, I hope you tried this out. Even using it on like a slimline card to create three scenes across the card can be really fun. There's a lot of different ways to do something like this. Now, another technique I wanted to do was sort of a layered floral technique using the framed floral set. I love these because they're kind of cool. I love these because they're really beautifully hand-drawn, almost like a painted effect, and they got some great solid areas and some to color in. So let's start off with this floral image up top. I love that it's got those leaves that are nice and solid, and some of these florals that can go in and color really easily. So I'll go in, and to do this stamping, I'm gonna use the stamp wheel. So I'll lift off that top plate. I'm going to place down my cardstock in the guide here. I have a full video on the stamp wheel that I'll link down below if you want to see it. And then I'm going to place down this image right onto my stark white cardstock. And I'm just gonna center it just in case if I use it just like this. I want it nice and centered. So I'm gonna go in, place this down into my stamp wheel to pick up the image, and then we'll rotate it so we can ink it up. So I'm gonna start off using a light green, like lighter gator, and I'm just gonna go in and ink up the whole image. So don't worry about inking up the flowers green. You're totally fine with that. I'm gonna ink everything up like this. Okay, then we'll flip it, lock it into place, and stamp it down. Super easy. So we don't get a great image the first time, so we can always stamp it again by going in and just re-inking it up. And because we're in the stamp wheel, it's gonna stamp in the exact same spot every time. So we'll flip it and stamp it down. All right, so we've got a pretty nice stamped image, and now I wanna go in and add some shading down to this. So I'm gonna go in using my detailed blending brushes from Altenew. I love this storage container too. I believe it's for lipsticks, but it stores these really nicely, so each one has its own little slot. I'll link down below to where I found it. For this, I'm gonna use a little bit of fake plant, which is quite a bit darker, and I love these little detailed blending brushes because we can tap on some color to add darker color into certain areas. So I'm just gonna add it kind of below some of the flowers to add a little bit of depth and dimension and shading to this image. It's really going to bring it to life. So then again, I'll flip this and stamp it down onto the surface, giving it some good pressure. And there you can see we've already added some of the shading. Now, if we want to, we can keep going in and different areas of the leaves to add even more depth and dimension to the image. And again, as you're doing this, don't worry about the flowers, we'll fix those in just a little bit. So once we've done stamped that down, we get a lot of color variation, which is really great. All right, so now we're gonna go in, spray this down just using a little bit of water, and we can clean off our image so we can stamp using a different color of ink. I'm gonna peel out my first sheet of stark white cardstock, and then I'm going to go in using another piece of my stark white cardstock to stamp down the next image. For this, I want a really nice crisp image, so I'm gonna go in using some VersaFine Clair, but of course you could go in with sort of a darker version of whatever you're going to color the flowers with, but I want just a nice crisp line, so I'm gonna stamp it using this black ink. So again, we can flip this over and stamp it right onto our cardstock, giving it some good pressure to make sure everything transfers. Perfect. And whenever I use that Versafine black ink, I want to set it in place using a bit of clear heat embossing powder, and we can heat set it until it's nice and shiny. Now I'm going to go in using those same Altenew detail brushes, starting off using a little bit of Rosy Cheeks, which is a nice light pink color, and I'm just going to go in and shade these in. This is super easy using a blending brush like this to add that color, and you don't have to worry about going outside the lines since we're going to fussy cut these out really easily. So I'll just go in and shade all of the different flowers and buds that I want to use on the card using the blending brush. Then I'll use a little bit of Bee Sting to add even more depth and dimension to the bottom of these images to really darken them in and give a little bit more depth. Okay, then I've loosely cut around the flowers and I'm just going to go in and do a little bit more of a detailed cut. There's not too many little details in this and you don't need to be super precise. Just cut around each individual flower that you want to be a different color than the background. Again, for this, I'm using those Fiskars Spring Assist scissors. I find them to be super helpful for detail cutting. So if you struggle with cutting in the details, I highly recommend these. It makes it so you don't have to do the motion of lifting out your scissors like this so that your hands don't get as tired and you get a really nice smooth line as you're cutting. All right, now before I adhere those on top, I wanna add something to add a little bit more green down on here. So I'm gonna go in using a little bit of that same color, which is Later Gator, and smoosh some onto an acrylic block. Then I'm going to take just a little bit of water, wet this down on the surface, and I'll grab my paintbrush and I'm just going to lightly flick on some color. This is a good way to get kind of light flicks and not too much color, but I just want it all across the card to add a little bit of a splatter to give it more of a mixed media look. And the water's also gonna react with some of the inking that we did on there and make some of it bleed. You could totally skip that step, but I love the texture and color that it adds to the background. But if you wanted a more clean look, just don't add those splatters. For the larger flowers, I'm going to pop them up on a little bit of foam tape to add some dimension, and then I'll just add them right over top of the stamped image on the card. And this adds tons of color to it. Then with the other blooms, I'll just puzzle them in right on top of the image by adding a little bit of adhesive down and then adhering them right onto the card. And check that out. I love how it easily adds color onto this image, adds a little bit of depth and dimension, and really steps the whole thing up. To complete this card, I'm gonna add some green cardstock to my top folding card base to turn it into a really great colored card base. Then I'm going to center this up and adhere it right down onto my card. I love the sentiment in the set, and to finish it off, I'm gonna use the sentiment that says, "Thanks for everything you do." I'm gonna use a little bit more of that same green colored cardstock and do some heat embossing. So for this, again, I'll use my clear sticky ink up the sentiment, and stamp it right down onto the cardstock. And then I'll use my white heat embossing powder, throw it over top, and tap off any of the excess, and heat set it till it's nice and bright white. Then again, I'll go in here and fussy cut right around this sentiment to give it more of a finished look. And then to finish this off, I'll just place this kind of overhanging that frame there, and I love how that sentiment looks. Here's a closer look at that finished card. I love the stamped image in green and the ink flick that we did in that green ink. I think that really added a ton of texture and brought the card to life. And then stamping again and coloring it in a separate color really adds tons of depth and dimension to the image. I just love how this card turned out and I can't wait to send it out. All right, you guys, I hope you really enjoyed today's video. I know it was kind of a hodgepodge of different techniques I wanted to try, but I hope you at least learned a lot. If you enjoyed it, give it a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below on which card and technique was your favorite. And also down there is a full supplies list to everything I used. Using those links helps support me, so I really appreciate it. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I'll see you guys soon in another card making and crafting video. Have a great day. Bye.